In August of 2016, just months after El Chapo was captured for the third and final time, his two sons went out to party in Puerto Vallarta. Ivan, age 35, and Jesus Alfredo Guzman, 29, had been vacationing in the resort city all week. Now it was Sunday, the night before Ivan's 36th birthday, and they went to an upscale restaurant called La Leche to celebrate. Six men and nine women joined them for the party. They were all driving Range Rovers and Escalades, befitting their status as narco royalty. They sat at a long candlelit table in the center of the all-white room. They ordered champagne and sang happy birthday. 3 hours of birthday partying passed and they were getting ready to leave, and then bam, shortly after midnight, six armed men burst into the birthday party, forced Ivan to his knees and grabbed Jesus. The Guzman brothers and the other men were hustled out to two waiting SUVs and driven off into the night, while the women were left unharmed. Without a shot being fired, El Chapo's two sons had been kidnapped in less than 2 minutes. El Chapo's sons had made the mistake of partying on the turf of Sinaloa's newest and most powerful rival, El Mencho. Eventually, El Chapo, who was in prison at this point, brokered the return of his sons for $2 million in cash and a large amount of drugs. And today, El Mencho has a bounty on his head of $10 million. Twice that of El Chapo when he was wanted, and El Mencho is considered the most powerful narco in Mexico and probably the most violent narco the failing Mexican state has ever seen. So just who is this El Mencho? Born in 1966 on an avocado farm in Michoacán State, right next to Guadalajara, the birthplace of the Mexican cartel system, El Mencho grew up poor. And he was in America by 1986, living in the Bay Area. It's unclear what his first legal name really is. El Mencho is a nickname for Nemesio in Spanish, and that probably is his original name, but it might be Ruben. Ruben, or Nemesio, got arrested by the San Francisco police at the age of 19 for stolen property and carrying a loaded gun. And according to border entry records, El Mencho crossed the U.S.-Mexico border several times during the late 80s under various aliases. The DEA and Mexican investigators believe it was during this time in the late 80s that he first got involved in a major way in the narcotics business, specifically meth production in California's Central Valley, which contains the two major cities of Fresno and Sacramento, an area with a heavy concentration of paisas, Mexican immigrants who come, for the most part, to work on farms. By 1989, El Mencho was arrested again in San Francisco for narcotic sales. He got deported to Mexico several months later, but re-entered the U.S. and came back again to Frisco. He had been slowly working his way up the narco food chain. And in September of 1992, he and his brother Abraham, according to court records, did a 5-ounce, $9,500 H deal at the Imperial Bar in San Francisco. Now, Abraham was in charge of the deal while El Mencho acted as a lookout. But though El Mencho was younger, he was the one savvy enough to notice that the buyers gave them perfectly stacked crisp bills, as if they had come from the bank, instead of giving them loose street money like normal. Turned out El Mencho was right. The money was from the bank because the buyers were the feds. He and his brother Abraham were charged in Sacramento federal court, and Abraham already had a record and could have gotten a life sentence, but El Mencho took some of the weight off his brother by accepting a 5-year plea deal for himself, which he probably could have avoided totally. So at the age of 30, El Mencho was paroled after serving 3 years in U.S. federal prison and deported back to Mexico. Now, here's where his story starts to show how totally incompetent and incapable and ridiculous Mexico sort of is. El Mencho, who's, mind you, freshly deported from the United States for dealing H, straight out of American federal prison, immediately gets a job as a cop in Jalisco State. So he works there for a few years, gets trained, and then he joins something called the Millennial Cartel, a small regional operation. In the Millennial Cartel, El Mencho started as a member of the Assassin Squad, and he helped protect the boss, In August of 2003, the boss of Millennio was arrested, and at the same time, Los Zetas, who was the military wing of the Gulf Cartel, carried out an armed offensive against the Millennials in Michoacan, and El Mencho and Millennio had to relocate to Jalisco because they couldn't stand up to Los Zetas. An alliance was formed with the Sinaloa Cartel subgroup headed by Ignacio Nacho Coronel. If the name Coronel sounds familiar, it's because it's the name of El Chapo's wife, Emma Coronel, who was Nacho Coronel's niece. Nacho is supposedly deceased, but there's some people who think he faked his death. Now, the Sinaloa Federation, as it's known, or the cartel as we call it, was and is made up of regional groups with the people at the top, like El Chapo, or now El Mayo and El Chapo's sons, providing the high-level political protection, logistics, and money laundering for the regional groups who grow poppy and weed and cook METH, and sometimes smuggle in coca from Colombia. Mencho, with his Jalisco Federale training, rose to be one of the Sinaloa cartel's security chiefs, and he was so fearsome that when the Flores twins were kidnapped by rogue elements of the Mexican government, he led several hundred pistoleros to cut the state troops off before they could take the Flores twins to the airport and send them back to the U.S. The Flores twins of Chicago were two of the biggest distributors for the cartel, sometimes turning in $20, $30 million a month for El Chapo's Sinaloa organization. And I'm sure El Chapo regrets getting those brothers out of that jam by calling his muscle El Mencho, because they went on to be two of the chief witnesses against him at his recent trial, which put him in Florence ADX for life. Now, ironically, this actually worked out for El Mencho, because with El Chapo gone and the Sinaloa hierarchy weakened, he was able to break loose and create his own cartel, the Jalisco New Generation, considered to now be the most powerful narco mafia in all of Mexico, and the most deadly since the decline of Los Zetas, the ex-soldiers who worked for the Gulf Cartel and drove up the record violence of a decade ago. And in fact, Jalisco New Generation and El Mencho's drive for dominance has helped propel the MUDER rate in Mexico to new record highs in 2018 and probably again in 2019. So now, El Mencho, believed responsible for ordering thousands of deaths, is with the possible exception of Rafael Caro Quintero, the aging dope lord still wanted for the 1985 Kiki Camarena case as the most wanted man in Mexico. Quintero actually was in prison from 85 to 2013 when a Mexican court let him out on a technicality, but then decided they shouldn't have and wanted him back in prison, but big shock, Quintero was gone. Quintero was one of the original architects of the Mexican cartel system, and he has yet to be caught. And he actually has a $20 million bounty on his head. Funny how the biggest narcos in Mexico seem to keep getting caught and getting out. Quintero did serve nearly 30 years though. El Mencho hasn't seen a day in Mexican prison to my knowledge. Wanted him back in prison, but big shock, Rafael Caro Quintero, one of the original architects of the Mexican cartel system out of Guadalajara, was gone in the wind, and he has yet to be caught, and there's a $20 million bounty out on him. Jalisco New Generation has been around for only about a half a decade, but with their swift rise, they've already achieved what took the Sinaloa guys nearly 20 years to do. The cartel has established trafficking routes in dozens of countries on six continents and controls territory spanning half of Mexico, including both the Atlantic and Pacific coasts and the southern and northern borders. They've increased their operations faster than any other criminal organization to date, said a classified Mexican intelligence report. And Mexico's attorney general declared them the most ubiquitous cartel in the country. That means they're everywhere. Direct attacks by the CJNG against Mexico's security forces has earned El Mencho a reputation among authorities as principal enemy of the state and as a dangerous criminal. Criminal groups like Los Zetas and the Knights Templar cartel were knocked off by CJNG, and now El Mencho's responsible for overseeing the entire drug trafficking operations of the Jalisco New Generation cartel and with a special emphasis on methamphetamine, which is highly profitable. And internationally, the CJNG has ties with criminal groups in the U.S. El Mencho, leader of the Jalisco New Generation Cartel, the new and improved El Chapo, with $10 million on his head, twice as much as Mr. Guzman had when he was supposedly public enemy number one. El Chapo's gone, but things have just gotten worse, and that is American dope.